Spaghetti.
I freaking love this spaghetti. This is the best spaghetti ever. Period. I bring you Chef Greg's spaghetti.
I know because she says so. He's a faggot boy. The TV says so. He's a junkie piece of because he says so. All that first class jets it brings me.
Spaghetti with garlic bread. That's what I'm gonna cook tonight. Spaghetti. Talk to me, baby.
I'm Greg Upshur, and we're here in Stockbridge in the old farmhouse kitchen. And as you already know, we're gonna make spaghetti today. Here's my ingredients. Big onion, fresh basil that was frozen from our garden. I'm gonna use a little bit of that. I got this fennel seed, some thyme, dried porcini, some bay leaf. I like to use the big bay leaves so people know that they're there and they don't choke on them. I'm gonna use some celery, some carrot, my favorite tomato sauce, a couple cans of that. I'm going to cook with virgin olive oil. I'm going to make some garlic bread. And I'm going to flavor this up with some ground turkey. I like the lean, not the extra lean. The extra lean's a little too dry, doesn't have much flavor. So that's what we got going on here. Let's get started. This is my stove. Electric Garland. Six burner. Got this from the UP. Bought it at an antique store. Paid 50 bucks for it. This baby's done a lot of entertaining. The problem is when I turn everything on, the neighborhood browns out. All right, let's get going on the spaghetti. Got my pan on. I use a lot of olive oil because you gotta have a lot of olive oil to make up for the lack of fat in the turkey, okay? Start out with this onion. I like to get the house smelling good right away. Want that in there. Here we go. All right. I put my onion in there. A little bit of carrot. I like a little carrot in there to sweeten it up. Watch closely, now I'm going to do this all fast. Some celery. I never used celery until I went out to eat out in New York City last year when I was doing a New York City triathlon. Hold the phone. All right, this is a shout out to Spence down there in Guatemala. Here's the spaghetti recipe. Now watch, pay attention. I like fennel seed. Get it in there with the heat. Some fresh thyme, lots of thyme. Okay, and the bay leaves. Get it all in there. I leave the mushrooms whole. For people that don't like mushrooms, I pull the mushrooms out for their portion. Okay, we've got to get this all loosened up. Yeah, look at that. It's beautiful already. We don't even have tomato sauce in there yet. Okay, let's loosen that up. Loosen it up. Now, while these things are cooking, I'm gonna get ready to cook up my spaghetti. If I can buy organic in a different type of thing, I do. I get the organic noodles. A little bit more expensive, but hey, we gotta start somewhere. I'll get these boiling and get them ready for when the sauce is done. All right, now if you watch, my hands never touch the turkey. All right, I never touch it. Keep contaminations down. And I just put little dollops in like this at a time. Make sure your pan's nice and hot. Way we can break it up easier. I gotta turn this around because this stove's a little uneven, just like me. Okay? Now, I'm not going to touch that. I want it to brown up on one side. If you stir it up now, it's going to release its liquids and water and cool the pot down, and we'll lose that nice caramelization of the albumins coming out of the meat. Yeah, now these veggies are cooked up pretty good. I'm adding my tomato sauce. Excellent sauce. And to that, I'm also going to add a couple of my frozen ice cube tray blobs of fresh basil my wife put together. And the turkey looks like it's browning up a little bit now. We'll get that loosened up. All right, my turkey's ready. I'm going to pour this in on top of it. We've got it all together now. By the way, Keith Famey, thanks for the paella pan that I got from you some way or another. I forget how. I think you left it at a restaurant. Now we'll just stir all that in. Oh, that smells fantastic. Just fantastic. I like these box graters because you can keep working with them without having to clean them. I did the carrot on one side, now I'm doing the cheese on the other. You get a bunch of different things going around, then you have a little food kaleidoscope. We're just gonna simmer this now for about 20 minutes and it's ready. However, if somebody has to run right now, they could eat some. And now to finish this spaghetti dish off, I'm gonna make some rockin' garlic toast. Garlic toast 101, here we go. My technique for garlic, cut almost all the way through it and roll it off. Got it? There we go. Yeah, oh, it all came off in one try. Whoopee! There you go, just dice it up like this. I slice it. And once again, I'm not the kind of guy that's gonna spend all day chopping up garlic, okay? Into this little mortar and pistol. Open that garlic up into the oil, a little more oil, okay, and then we just take that and liberally brush it on that toast. I'm not going to assume that everybody knows how to cook noodles, so I'm going to give you a quick lesson. Water's, lots of water, boiling good, add some salt. Salt should, you should be able to taste the salt in the water, let me put it that way. If you like things saltier, add more salt. While the water's boiling, I add my noodles. I'm gonna let these get in there. I'm gonna stir them a little bit, cook them for about, 8-9 minutes. Okay, my garlic toast went in. Don't leave the kitchen. Remember, it's in the oven. Get off the phone and cook, or you'll burn it up sooner than you think. This is looking really nice. I like it a little burnt around the edges, because I like burnt. That's some classic garlic bread right there. That'll finish it off nice. From my kitchen to yours, have a nice dinner. It is delicious.
Delicioso!
I suppose it's the best spaghetti in the world.
Don't try this one.
Right, Mary?
Get the recipe,
right? Yeah. Get a call from Mary for Ben and Ben's dad. Real close to